So here's another daily do from your friendly local dermatologist. All right, so I want you outside hiking and biking and walking around and enjoying yourself, but occasionally you can overdo it. So what do you do if you have a big blister on your foot from too much trauma or another area too much trauma? Now, I'm not talking about blisters that come from medical conditions. I'm talking about blisters that come from repetitive trauma, like going for a 10-mile hike in a new pair of shoes that you haven't broken in. The first thing is to keep the area clean. So clean it gently, a gentle cleanser, and water and pat dry. Leave the blister alone. Just leave it alone, guys. It is forming the perfect biologic band-aid that protects the raw skin underneath from the blistered skin on top. So if you think about it, you have good, healthy skin, and then something causes a blister to form. And then you have this blister up here, which means this is the top dead part of the skin that's always been there, that used to be down here, but now is up here. And down here is the underbelly of the skin, and it's raw. And if you rip that blister off, this raw skin that was meant to have this protective coating on it, it no longer has a protective coating. And so it's open to things like infections or worse, scarring or fill in the blank. So you don't want to rip the blister off. Just let it happen naturally. Now, if you have to pop it, then you can just, with a sterile pin that you've sterilized, put one small little hole in there, let the fluid drain out, and put a bandage on top. Don't rip the skin off, because again, this up here that formed the blister, that used to be great, healthy skin, and as it goes back down, it'll form the perfect biologic band-aid. Now, if you have a blister and it's painful, or the redness is starting to spread, or anything that's happening that isn't normal, you have to go see your doctor, because you can get infections or other problems from blisters. But please, don't rip the blister off. If you have to, you can pop it, but any unusual symptoms, fevers, chills, night sweats, pain that's spreading, anything, redness that's spreading, anything that's different, go see your doctor.